Hi guys, good evening everyone. Happy Diwali. To start with, happy Diwali to everyone. Today we are going to talk about something very specific. We'll be discussing the spotlight flashcards for the month of July 2019. We might not be able to complete the entire July flashcards because it's a lot, about 60 to 70 pages. But in any case, it's going to be a fun session because it's going to be completely engaging. I will be engaging with you guys directly in these questions that we're going to pick up, and you have to be active enough. Okay, so that's something that we're going to do. Secondly, the timings have come up. It is 45 minutes for reasoning and 25 minutes for everything else. Now, not a bad offer by RBI, I would say. 45 minutes in reasoning should give you some confidence, but 25 minutes in quant will leave a lot of you, disappointed, so to say. So what we're going to do is understand that and a lot of things about what to do in these last 12 days, how to make them more productive in the next session, which we're going to have tomorrow morning because it's Diwali tomorrow. So everybody will be at home. The least you can do is join me up for a session where we will understand what to do in the last 12 days, how to organize them, how to use them to your maximum potential, and how to revise and what to revise, what not to revise. All those things we will be discussing along with a discussion on the new timings that have been provided by RBI and how they're going to affect us. But today it's going to be very specific. We'll be talking about July flashcards. We'll be revising a major portion of July flashcards. We'll try that, and whatever remains, we'll try and revise that later. Okay. Now, these sessions have been limited to enrolled students in the past, and I am revising as much as possible with the enrolled students through live sessions on a regular basis, and I'll keep doing that till the time we have the exam. So the target is to revise June, July, August, September. August and September are almost done. August is done. September, only 10 pages are left. July, whatever is done today is going to be added, and along with that we will have other sessions for July, and then we'll have the June sessions, and after that of course October. So that is how we're going to move forward with the enrolled students in case they have missed out on the announcements that I've been making. Okay, so we're going to wait for another 2-3 minutes, and then I will be starting with the session. In that time period, if you have any doubts, you can tell me your doubts, whatever problems you might be facing, and then we'll start. So first comment is by Dia, says, yesterday only came to know you about your background in Quora, 3 interview in UPSC, twice in RBI. Yes, yes, that's happened. Some interviews in UPSC, some in RBI. Yes, that's the background. Thank you for the appreciation, and hope if you're preparing for RBI, very sincerely hope that you make it this time. Thank you so much, Simply Built, for that appreciation. I would like to say that it's Diwali time, and I don't expect so many of you to actually, come online, spend time on, something that I'm doing. And I think it's the appreciation also should be given to you. You guys have been very sincere, I would say, especially the enrolled students have been very, very sincere. The group that we have for the enrolled ones is very active, and I want majority of those students to get through, and I know that all of you guys who have been very religiously and very sincerely studying, if you're smart enough and you pull off in these last 12-15 days, you will be able to get through. For RBI, lucky, at least 5 months, and you can go on if you have time, but 5 months is good enough. Akash cutoff will decrease certainly. By how much nobody can tell, depends upon the level of the exam, but yes, it's going to increase, it's going to reduce. Yes, July is much bigger than the rest of the months. He says his brother is working in TCS Mexico. It does not matter which company is in work, is he working in? He's working in Mexico. That means his incomes are going to be counted as a non-resident income and not as a resident income. He's not going to be a resident of India, but he is a citizen of India. That means his incomes are going to come into national income, but not in the GDP, because in GDP only the incomes of people who are in India are counted. Mood to nahi ho raha, but we have to keep going, and it's going to be more interesting this time. It's not just me who's going to tell you whatever current affairs are there. We're going to have a quiz kind of a thing. ट्वेंटी aspirant Siri Vaishnavi, I would say focus on static portion right now. Focus on the syllabus of both phase 1 and phase 2. Okay? Leave out the current affairs at this point of time. You can join us for this session just for awareness, but otherwise not required. Cutoff is going to reduce. We don't know by how much. Depends on the level of the examination. Thanks, Anshul. Yes, Spotlight. I've spent a lot of time on Spotlight. The flashcards also have taken a lot of time, but they've come out very well. Yes, go through the interim budget too. This time it's much better. Last time Spotlight was not so good compared to this year, if we are relative. So this year's Spotlight is much better. We are expecting at least 65 to 70 from this year's Spotlight. Okay, let us start with the session. Let me just see if everything is all right with respect to what you can see and what you cannot see. Perfect. I think good enough. Yeah. Okay. So I'm going to be throwing some questions at you, and you will be answering them, and then I will take you to the information available attached to them. This is flashcards only, so the information is on the left hand side, the questions are on the right hand side, and that we will go and try and cover the entire Spotlight. Okay, the answers are up. Who has become the first civil officer to climb North America's highest peak, Denali in Alaska? The answers that are coming up are B, Aparna Kumar. Let's have a look at and see if we have some other information. Aparna Kumar, who is also an IPS officer, an officer of Indo-Tibetan Border Police, has become the first civil officer to climb North America's highest peak, Denali in Alaska. Okay, the next question. Who will head the high-powered committee formed by PM Modi to transform agriculture? High-powered committee formed by Modi to transform agriculture. Let's have the answer, guys. Jagan Mohan Reddy, Pinarayi Vijayan, Arvind Kejriwal, Devendra Fadnavis, Nitish Kumar. A very easy question. Lot of news about this as well. What is the answer, guys? Let's have the answer, guys. Okay, somebody says D, Devendra Fadnavis, somebody says A, Jagan Mohan Reddy. So we have some confusion there. D, everybody else says D. So the answer obviously has to be D if everybody says D. Let's check. Yes, high powered committee formed convened by Devendra Fadnavis to double farmers' income by 2022 has been formed. Let's come to the next one. UGC has launched a new scheme called STRIDE. What is the full form of STRIDE? Please give me the full form of STRIDE, all of you. To boost research culture in India. What does E stand for? So you have to tell me what does E stand for, and then the full form of STRIDE as well. Please tell me the full form of STRIDE as well after we're done with the full form of E. So what does E stand for? Number one, you have to write that down. And secondly, you have to tell me the full form of STRIDE. So we are not going to limit ourselves to only A, B, C, D. We are going to add on and learn about some new things as well, and that will help us in revising. Okay, everybody says economy. Let's have the full form of STRIDE, guys. That is very important. So write down the full form of STRIDE. It's not going to take long. I'll be waiting for you. Somebody says education as well, so some confusion there. Majority of students are saying economy, somebody says education. Let's have the full form. Malik says, scheme for transdisciplinary research of for India's developing economy. Yes. Scheme for transdisciplinary research in India's developing economy. Somebody says strengthening India's developing economy. Right. Majority of you have got it right. Yes. STRIDE stands for Scheme for Transdisciplinary Research for India's Developing Economy to boost research and innovation. Some more information. Bhushan Patwardhan Committee has been set up by UGC to examine the implementation of entire scheme. So that is another area where a question can be asked. Another question, Bhushan Patwardhan Committee for what? The purpose can be asked or the purpose can be given and you can be asked the name of the committee. Okay. Next question, Garuda is a joint exercise of India and, I'm not giving you the options this time. If it is Germany, you'll get it right. If it's not Germany, you have to tell me which country along with India comes out with a joint exercise called as Garuda. Let's have the answer, guys. The name is Garuda. Joint exercise, it's a Hindi name, probably in Ramayana or Mahabharata, I don't know. But Garuda is a joint exercise of India and France. Somebody says France. Malik says France. Sunil says France. Malik is smart enough. He is coming out with the answers fast. I want other guys to come out with the answers fast and beat him. Okay, majority of you are coming out with France. Let's have the answer. Bilateral exercise Garuda 6 is between Indian Air Force and French Air Force. Okay, nice one. Right answer there. The answer option would be D in this case. Next question. With which ministry has Ministry of Ayush signed an MOU to set up Ayush Grid project? You have to tell me the full form of Ayush as well, number one in this question. And with which ministry has Ayush ministry signed an MOU to set up Ayush Grid project? So what is this grid all about? Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Ministry of Electronics, Ministry of Coal, Ministry of Science or Ministry of Power? Malik says the first one to answer, MeitY. Sunil also says EIT. Probably I am assuming he wanted to say MeitY. Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, that's option B. Let's see if he got it right or not, or all of you got it right or not. What is the full form of Ayush? Can somebody write it down and tell me? What is the full form of Ayush? Ayurveda, Yoga, Yunani, Siddha, Homeopathy. Nice one. Okay. Ministry of Ayush, Ministry of Electronics and Ministry of Ayush have signed an MOU to digitize the entire Ayush sector by setting up Ayush Grid project. So it is an electronic grid which is going to be set up in order to digitize the entire Ayush setup in the country. Next one, Ministry of Commerce and Industry will set up Cooperative Sector Export Promotion Forum to double the exports from 2.75 trillion to about dash by 2024-25. So Ministry of Commerce has set up a export promotion forum to double the exports from this. So this is our present value of exports. Remember this, guys, very important. And what is the target? To about dash, I think it should be lakh crore, not crore. It is lakh crore. Okay. Along with every answer, every option, you have lakh attached. Okay. So we have five options here. 10, 15, 7, 9.5 or 12. 7 trillion. Somebody says A. A is 10. Somebody says 7. B. Rajneesh said 7. Sarvagya said A. That is 10. Everybody else says 7. I'm assuming on you guys that the answer is 7. Let's see what the answer is. Yes. They've come up with an MOU to double the exports from 2.75 trillion to almost 7. Not double probably, but to increase. Next question, what is the percentage of deaths caused by non-communicable diseases in 2016 according to India Health of Nations State report? This is the latest data that they have come out with. Percentage of deaths caused by non-communicable diseases in 2016. 61.8, 71, 51, 21 or 35. Let's have the answer, guys. What is the percentage of deaths caused by non-communicable diseases? Is it more than the deaths caused by communicable or less than the deaths caused by communicable diseases? What is the situation right now in India? Okay. Rajneesh says 61.8, Malik says 61.8, Shubham says 61.8, Jasleen also says A 61.8. Okay, let's not wait for the answer, let's jump to the information. Yes, it is 61.8. That gives us another information that the deaths caused by communicable diseases are 38.2. So remember that, okay, do not forget that. They can ask in this way as well. They like all these factual questions, and it's a very important fact. Therefore, I have put it out here. Okay. Okay. What is the percentage of children with disability attending schools according to UNESCO's first of its kind report, State of Education Report for India 2019, Children with Disabilities? UNESCO's State of Education Report. So, one question is, State of Education Report is released by which organization? The answer is UNESCO. What is the percentage of children with disability attending schools? That you have to tell me. Percentage of children with disability attending schools. So if there are 100 children with disability, how many of them are attending schools? That is the question here. Okay, a lot of variations here. Somebody says 71, somebody says 20, somebody says 61%. Somebody says, does anybody say 90? Let's have the answer, guys. UNESCO has come out with the first report, State of Education Report, and they focused on disability this time. As per 2011 census data, more than 78 lakh children with disabilities reside in India between 5 to 19 years, out of which 27% never attended any educational institution. So 61% are attending educational institutions. Out of this, 12% drop out eventually, and the disparity among disabilities, 20% of visual and hearing impaired children with disabilities, and more than 50% children with multiple disabilities have never been to school. Okay, it recommends to amend the right to education to link it with right of persons with disabilities. So if you have a question in the future on right of persons with disability, right to education, let's say there is a question in the essay. The essay topic talks about, let's say, education. And then they ask for, in the conclusion, of course, you have to give a way forward. And if possible, in this way forward, WF, you can provide this recommendation, which is going to be very helpful in scoring more marks, because it will leave a very positive impact and will be something new for the examiner to read. Okay, so that is the way you try to increase your scores. Which state has stopped the agricultural marketing and farmer friendly reforms index 2019? UP, MP, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh or Punjab? Agricultural marketing and farmer friendly reforms index 2019. Why is this important? Because ENAM, the government is trying to implement ENAM and remove APMCs, number one. And secondly, because the idea or the objective of double farmers' income, because they're trying to double farmers' income by 2022, and that's why they can ask questions related to that as well. Okay, let's have the answer, guys. Maharashtra, everybody says C, majority of the students say C. Let's have a look at the information that's here. Maharashtra was ranked first in Niti Aayog's Agricultural Marketing and Farmer Friendly Reforms, which ranks states, UTs on provisions of Model Agriculture APMC Act 2003. Okay, the next question, what is the sex birth ratio of the nation in 2018-19? Sex birth ratio of the nation, girls is to boys, 911, 921, 931, 941 or 951. So these are the options. Let's have the answer, guys. What is the sex birth ratio of India? They are referring it to India in 2018-19. Pranjal, thanks for telling me. Yes, released by Niti Aayog. So that is another question that can be asked from the previous discussion that we have. Information through the previous question. Increase to 931 from 918. Nice one. Malik says, Rishikesh says 931. Pranjal also says 931. Majority of the students here say 931. Okay, let's come to the information and see if that is right. According to Ministry of Women and Child Development, sex birth ratio has increased to 931 as against 923 in 2015-16 at the national level. So it was 918, I think, according to the census, then increased to 923, and now it is stands at 931. Okay, so if there is any essay on women, you have to mention that. With which country has India partnered for training of astronauts for Gaganyaan mission? With which country has India partnered for training of astronauts for the Gaganyaan mission? What is Gaganyaan mission? You have to tell me that as well. What is Gaganyaan mission and with which country has India partnered? I'm not very sure about that, if Bihar's sex ratio at birth is better than national sex ratio at birth. I'm not very sure about that. We'll have to check that. Russia, okay, everybody says Russia. D, is that the right answer? I would request other students not to follow whatever is being answered. If you think that the answer is something else, please mention it. Like Shashank just mentioned, A, USA. It might actually be A, USA. So you have to be confident about your options. They might come out to be true. And if they are wrong, you will never forget that question. Okay? Don't follow the crowd. The answer in this case is Russia. ISRO and Russia, GlobCosmos, signed a contract for training of Indian astronauts for Gaganyaan. Gaganyaan, yes, as the name itself suggests, sending 3 persons to space by 2022. That's another question. By which year do we want to implement or make Gaganyaan a reality? The answer is 2022. Next question. Where was the third edition of International Sunflower Seed and Oil Conference 2019 held? I believe not so much an important question, but in any case, let's discuss it if it's here. Third edition of International Sunflower Seed and Oil Conference 2019, where was it held? Let's have the answer, guys, of this question. Maharashtra, somebody says Maharashtra. Mumbai in Maharashtra. Okay. Let's see if we have some other answers. Maharashtra is A, option A. Okay, everybody says Maharashtra. Yes, it was held in Mumbai. India is the largest importer of sunflower oil, with imports of about 2.8 million tons against global imports of around 9.6 million tons. Okay, that's why it was important. What is the name of the operation launched by BSF to fortify anti-infiltration grid alongside Indo-Pakistan border? Name of the operation launched by BSF to fortify anti-infiltration grid alongside Indo-Pakistan border. Operation Parakram, Operation Vichar, Operation Sudarshan, Tantrika or Utsa. Let's have the answer, guys. See, these questions are important. This session holds a lot of importance for the reason that I have just released or given July flashcards to enrolled students. And other than enrolled students, I believe there are a lot of other students who are studying on their own sitting here. So it will actually check where do you stand. Everybody says, see, Operation Sudarshan. Let's have a look at the information. Yes, it says Operation Sudarshan to strengthen the anti-infiltration grid in Jammu and Punjab alongside India-Pakistan border, because BSF stays on the border there. Not the Indian Army stays inside. BSF is the one responsible for the actual border. Where will the first Six Sigma Institute of Mountain Medicines and High Altitude Rescue be established? Six Sigma Institute of Mountain Medicines and High Altitude Rescue. Where is it going to be established? Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, Arunachal, Sikkim or Nagaland? What is the answer, guys? Let's have the answer as fast as possible. Six Sigma Institute of Mountain Medicines and High Altitude Rescue to be established where? Uttarakhand, Himachal, Arunachal, Sikkim or Nagaland. Flashcards have been put in for the enrolled students. They are there in the crash course. They put in the crash course. June is also done. It'll be uploaded in the crash course only tonight. Everybody, majority of the students say Uttarakhand. Some students said Himachal. Let's have a look at what is the right answer in this case. Is it Uttarakhand or is it Himachal? Asia's first Six Sigma Institute of Mountain Medicines is going to be established in Rudraprayag in Uttarakhand. So our right answer is A in this case. Well done, majority of you got it wrong. Where will India's largest sewage treatment plant be built? A very irrelevant question, but Majority of the questions here are irrelevant in any case. Largest sewage treatment plant, where is it going to be built? UP, Gujarat, Karnataka, Delhi or Meghalaya? What is the answer, guys? Let's have the answer as fast as possible. Delhi, okay. Malik says Delhi, Jasleen says Uttar Pradesh. Everyone else is moving to Delhi. Let's see what is the right answer. Okay. Majority of you say Delhi, so it should be Delhi. India's largest sewage treatment plant will be built in Okhla, New Delhi at a cost of 1161 crore in partnership with the French company Suez Group. Another question that can be asked from this is, with which company has India partnered in order to build the largest, country's largest sewage treatment plant in Delhi? So that is another question that can be asked from you. So keep that in mind also, it's a French company. Next question, which state has mandated all the state-run universities to provide 1% reservation for girl child of sexually exploited women or Devadasis? Which state has mandated state-run universities to provide 1% reservation for girl children of sexually exploited women or Devadasis? What is the answer, guys? Varun, the sectional timings in mock tests have already been changed. They were changed yesterday only. Delhi, Assam, Maharashtra, Karnataka or Odisha? What is the answer, guys? Let's have the answers on the table first. Which state has mandated? Karnataka. Okay, everybody says Karnataka. D, Deepthi says E, Odisha. Let's see if it is Karnataka or Odisha. Shashank also says Odisha. Okay, Karnataka. Karnataka's Higher Education Board has mandated quota of 1% for daughters of sexually exploited women in all state-run universities in order to promote, because they're all single, majority of them are single moms, to promote their children better education. Which of the following animal is not a part of immuno-contraceptive measures project of Environment Ministry? So which animal is not a part of controlling the population, as simplifying we can say, the project of Environment Ministry? Elephant, monkey, wild boar, blue bull or tiger? Which of the following is not a part of this project of the Environment Ministry? Let's have the answer, guys. Tiger, Herschel says tiger, which is option E. Tiger is option E. Let's have the answers by other people as well and see who gets it right, who gets it wrong. Rishikesh says elephant. Paltu also says elephant. Somebody says monkey. Dipti says monkey. Srini says elephants. Everyone else says elephant. Tiger is yes, option E. An important question, this question can actually be asked in the exam. Immuno-contraceptive measures have been launched by Ministry of Environment for population management of four species. Which are these? Elephant, wild boar, monkey and blue bull, which is Nilgai. Therefore, tiger is not one of the options. First phase will be launched in Uttarakhand. I think it's a very logical question. You're already facing the problem of less tigers in the country. A shortage of tigers, and over that I believe the elephants are also not doing well. Therefore I don't understand why elephant has been included in this. They already, you know, procreate at such a slow speed. Therefore I do not understand why elephant is a part of it, but tiger certainly is not a part of it. Okay, next question. Which state has launched the Meri Fasal Mera Pyora web portal? Which state? Now, I had given a government scheme revision document in which all the portals were also given towards the end. In that, this name, portal of this name was also available. Meri Fasal Mera Pyora web portal, which state? Harshal says Haryana. Let's have the answer, guys. Harshal says Haryana. Everybody else is still thinking. Shivam says Haryana, option A. Okay, everybody here says Haryana. An easy question. Haryana has launched Meri Fasal Mera Byora portal so that farmers can self-report their land and crop details on this portal and get the benefits of several government schemes directly. Which company has recently signed an MOU with BRICS Chamber of Commerce to promote trade and investments among BRICS? Which company has recently signed an MOU with BRICS to promote trade and investments among BRICS? China Investment Corporation, Bharat Chamber of Commerce, National Financial System, Public Investment Corporation, or Russian Venture Company? Which company has signed an MOU with BRICS Chamber of Commerce to promote trade and investments among BRICS? Let's have the answer, guys. Bharat Chamber of Commerce, it should logically be B. Pranjal says, no idea. There's nothing wrong in not having an idea. Additional information or additional knowledge is always helpful. Majority students say B. Sama saying C, National Financial System of Brazil. The answer is B. Bharat Chamber of Commerce have signed an MOU for promoting trade and investment among BRIC countries and eastern part of India in particular. Another question that can be asked, which part of India is going to be helped or is going to be promoted through this MOU with BRICS Chamber of Commerce? Okay, before we move forward, something that I believe is very important that you should know. A lot of students, both enrolled and non-enrolled students, were studying on their own, and enrolled students who have enrolled in the past 30-35 days have been very confused regarding how to prepare for the examination in this time period. And one thing that I normally see is that students take a course or they're already enrolled for the last 4-5 months, and even without looking at the entire course, they often have a lot of doubts, which is obvious, but I would recommend that please spend some time on the course itself and try and explore it. You will find everything is available there. Instead of running after information or handouts from other institutes, first cover what you have paid for if you're an enrolled student, okay, specifically. So what happens is a lot of students call me and ask me the same things again and again, and therefore sometimes I snap off on them. Because I also expect students at times to, you know, go through the course thoroughly, in at least have a look at the entire course and the contents thoroughly, and then see, okay, this all is covered here, XYZ is not covered according to B. Now let me go to Anuj sir and ask him, where is it? Okay, instead of that, they just look for something. Okay, July current affairs, not available in current affairs, let me go to him. Make a list of what all you think should be there. Make a list of what all is there. You can just take a printout directly, and then you would be able to sync both of them perfectly. That is the most important thing that I wanted to mention. So in case I have snapped at somebody for things like this, expecting that students also be a part of this exercise and not ask very obvious question of where XYZ is, because it is already there, so have a hard look, then don't feel bad about it, okay? Don't feel bad about it. I would apologize if you have felt bad about it, but I've just snapped at you expecting something out from the students. Okay, let's jump to the next question. Which company is, we've already answered this, sorry. Where will India's first elephant rehabilitation center be opened? India's first elephant rehabilitation center by the government. Thanks, Jasleen. Let's move with the question and the answer. Where will India's first elephant rehabilitation center be opened? Goa, Kerala, Maharashtra, Uttarakhand, or Telangana? Herschel, again the first one to answer Kerala. Let's have someone beat Herschel and answer it faster than everyone else, faster than him. Kerala, everybody says Kerala, that is option B. Let's come to the answer and see. Yes, India's first elephant rehabilitation center to be opened in Kottur, Kerala. I believe this is going to be a rehabilitation center by the government. There are already some NGOs carrying out rehabilitation center. In fact, there is an NGO called Wildlife SOS. Wildlife SOS. This year only, I believe in July, I went, not in Agra, it was in Mathura. I went early morning to their rehabilitation center in order to donate some of my savings to that center. So it's a rehabilitation center that they have in Mathura. So all the students who live nearby or in Delhi, I would suggest that early morning you can take your car or your bike. You can go to their center in near Mathura and visit them, donate if you want to, not donate if you don't want to. But it's a beautiful rehabilitation center for elephants. You will learn a lot. Yes, his internet is a little fast. I know that. I guess that is right. Which state will produce its own seeds under the brand name of Sahbij? The next question, which state will produce its own seeds under the brand name of Sahbij? Madhya Pradesh, Karnataka, Orissa, Uttarakhand or Bihar? Let's have the answer, guys. Which state will produce its own seeds under the brand name of Sahbij? Madhya Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, everybody says Madhya Pradesh. Who was the first one? Harshal was the first one to answer. Pranjal was the second one to answer. Okay, let's have the answer. Madhya Pradesh State Cooperative Seed Federation will produce its own seeds under the brand name of Sahbij from next Rabi season. Wonderful. Next question, when was Mission Rakshagyan Shakti launched? Mission Rakshagyan Shakti. What is the purpose of this Mission Rakshagyan Shakti? Rakshagyan Shakti. 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. Let's have the answer, guys. The question is, when was Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti launched? Options are 14, 15, 16, 17 or 18. Herschel says 2018. Pranjal, what is the answer? Mushfiq Imran Khan says 18, Sarvagya says 18, everybody now is saying 18. Do not follow Harshal, he is also wrong at times, in case you are. Okay, nice one. Intellectual Property Facilitation Cell, National Research Development Corporation and Department of Defense, as you pointed out, Defense IPR, to boost Mission Raksha Gyan Shakti, the mission was launched to infuse intellectual property culture in defense manufacturing. Wonderful answer there, Sarvagya. The first one to mention the objective of Mission Rakshagyan. Next question, which of the following company has got the order of for producing 1000 Barak 8 medium range surface to air missile for Indian Air Force and Indian Army? Which company produces Barak 8 medium range surface to air missile and has got the order of producing 1000? The reason it has been asked is because it's a big order, 1000 Barak 8 medium range surface to air missiles. Otherwise, this would not have been an important question. Okay, what are the answers, guys? D. Kalyani Rafale. Yes. Everybody says D. Who was the first one? Saranya was the first one to answer this. Nice one. Somebody says, Mushfiq says, Larsen and Toubro. Let's see what is the answer. The answer is Kalyani Rafale Advance has got 100 million order for manufacturing 1000 Barak 8 missile. Joint venture. CRAS is a joint venture of Israel's Rafale Advanced Systems and India's Kalyani Strategic Systems Limited. Okay. Who was awarded with the annual Gandhi Mandela Peace Prize? Very important question. Very high chances of this question being asked in the examination. Yes, Sarvagya, very nice information there. Barak, originally of Israel, yes. Joint venture of two companies, yes, mentioned there. Nice, well done. Annual Gandhi Mandela Peace Prize or Peace Medal 2019. Dalai Lama, Margaret Thatcher, Thich Nhat Hanh, Jacinda Ardern or Chip Burke? Everybody says C. Thich Nhat Hanh. Herschel says C. Rishikesh says C. Shubham says C. I'm not very sure. I think this question was also in KBC, if I'm not wrong. Although I'm not very sure, because July current affairs, if I'm not wrong, was made by me, the daily ones. That's why I'm getting confused, but I'm recalling that this question was also in KBC. Annual Gandhi Mandela Peace Medal. Okay, let's have the answer here. First ever Gandhi Mandela Peace Initiative was organized by Dr. Anurag Batra of Billy Foundation. So that's another question that can be asked. And Tarina Patel of Raman Bhai Patel Foundation was awarded to Zen Master Thich Nhat Hanh. So he's a Zen master, so should be from either Myanmar or Vietnam. Yes, should be from Vietnam. I'm not very sure though about that. Okay, which state, next question, has become the first one to approve a water policy of its own? West Bengal, Mizoram, Meghalaya, Arunachal or Assam? Let's have the answer, guys. Which state has become the first one to approve a water policy of its own? Meghalaya. Maulik says Meghalaya. Good evening, Anusha. Welcome to the session. Harshal says Meghalaya. Shubham says Meghalaya. Everybody is saying Meghalaya. Wonderful. Meghalaya has become the first state to approve its own state water policy to conserve the catchment areas of water bodies to prevent them from degradation, because so much rain in Meghalaya and yet Meghalaya is facing water problems. How many species of orchids are found in India according to Orchids of India, a pictorial guide? Let's have the answer, guys. 1256, 2806, 5396, 8160, 7529. Meghalaya, West Bengal. West Bengal is wrong. 125 says 6 says Herschel. Shubham says A. Pranjal says A. Rishikesh says A. Majority of the students are saying A. 1256. Okay, let's jump to the answer. Botanical Survey of India has released the first comprehensive census of orchids, and that's why this is important, because this is the first comprehensive census of orchids. Named as Orchids of India Pictorial Guide, so the name is also important, which mentioned that total number of orchids is 1256. And Arunachal Pradesh has the highest number of orchid species with 612. So that's another question that can be asked in the examination. Next question, which of the following statements is not true about the recent amendments to PM Fasal Bima Yojana? Insurance to be made voluntary for all farmers, a state level corpus fund and national level insurance risk pool will be created to bring transparency in PM Fasal Bima Yojana. Already answered here, so I believe no point in discussing this question, but even then let's do it. States will get flexibility to provide customized add-on products. Interest subvention on loans will be provided to farmers. Premium ceiling will be at 25% for land with more than 50% of area with crops. Okay, this tells us the amendments that have been made in the PM Fasal Bima Yojana. Yes, insurance is now mandatory for all farmers. A state level corpus fund and national level insurance risk pool will be created to bring transparency in PM Fasal Bima Yojana. States will get flexibility to provide customized add-on products, and premium ceiling will be at 25% for land with more than 50% of area with crops. Okay, so this is all where the changes are mentioned. Insurance made mandatory, flexibility to states to provide add-on products, state level corpus funds and premium ceiling set at 25% for land with more than 50% of area with crops, and 30% is the premium on ceiling with areas for land with less than 50% area under crop cultivation. High premiums are to be eliminated. The purpose is to eliminate high premiums. E is not the answer. E is correct. D is incorrect. Okay. Let's jump to the next question. Who heads the Commission of National Digital Health Blueprint? Commission of National Digital Health Blueprint. That's what's mentioned there. 50% of land, more than 50% of land. Okay, let's jump to the next question directly. Who heads the Commission of National Digital Health Blueprint? Nice one, Pranjal. Thanks for the information. I'm sure flashcards are going to help you a lot. Okay, everybody says Satya Narayana. A, option A. Somebody who does not agree with option A, please tell me. Somebody thinks that the answer is something else, you can come up with your comments. Who heads the Commission of National Digital Health Blueprint? Yes, the answer is A, Satya Narayan. Satya Narayan, J. Satya Narayana has prepared the report called National Digital Health Blueprint. Next question, according to the new definition of major airports proposed in the Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of Amendment Bill, what is the new threshold set for annual passenger traffic? New threshold set for annual passenger Okay, let's have the answer, guys. 35. Somebody says 35. First one to answer, Malik. Then Herschel, 35. Rekha, 35. Everybody says 35, option D. Airports Economic Regulatory Authority of India Amendment Bill has been passed by Rajya Sabha. Let's have a look at the amendments. Total 16 airports will come under AERA, while the others will continue to be under Civil Aviation Ministry. New definition of major airports, the bill increases the threshold of passenger traffic for becoming a major airport to be over 35 lakh from current 15 lakh. This means that if the air passenger traffic is more than 35 lakh, only then will an airport be counted as a major airport. Okay, very important question. Next question, how many people were suffering from hunger according to the state of food security and nutrition in the world in 2019? In the world in 2019. So, how many people were suffering from hunger according to the state food security and nutrition in the world in 2019? The options are in front of you. No, answers come after the options only. I believe your internet is a little more slow than the others. $820 million. A, everybody says $820 million. Bankwala Babu says session kab khatam hoga. When all of you get tired, then the session will get over. The show must go on, as everybody says. The session must go on if you guys are ready. When you guys get tired, you can tell me, we can end with the session. Okay, everybody says $820 million. Let's have a look. UN's report, the state of food security and nutrition. So the name of the report and released by which institution? Released by the United Nations. That's important for us. Okay. Safeguarding against economic slowdown and downturn mentions that 820 million people were facing hunger in 2018. In India, the number of undernourished people was 194 million. However, in India, obese people grew from 24 million to 34 million. So malnutrition does not... quick information, malnutrition does not only mean undernutrition. Malnutrition also means overnutrition, which in this case becomes obesity. So if there is any essay or anything on malnutrition, you have to remember that it's not only undernutrition, also overnutrition. Prevalence of wasting in children, 20.8%, while obesity in the adult population increased to 3.8% in 2016. Try to remember these numbers as well. Very important. Next question. With which organization has Department of Telecommunication signed an MOU to develop the first of its kind broadband readiness index? With which organization has DOT signed an MOU to develop first of its kind broadband readiness index? Very important, because it's the first time India is coming out with something like this. The options are ICERT, Indian Computer Emergency Response Team, NIC, Center for Development of Advanced Computing, Indian Council for Research in International Economic Relations, National Institute of Electronics and IT, NIEIT. The screen is already zoomed in. I believe I cannot zoom it much more than this, because then you will not be able to see anything. The screen is so big, I don't understand. Okay, everybody says C, Center for Development of Advanced Computing. Center for Development of Advanced Computing. Sarvagya says ICRIAR. Pranjal also says, Harshal also says D, which is ICRIAR. Sarvagya says ICRIAR. Okay, let's see. DOT signed an MOU with ICRIAR to develop a broadband readiness index for states and UTs. What is the purpose? To rank states or UTs on the basis of the readiness for improving digital infrastructure. And this will help the states who are not doing so well to attract more investments. And states who are already doing well, the less risk averse investors would also want to get in there to have, a bite of the pie. It is D. The answer is D. With which company has Tata Trust collaborated to launch the Internet Sathi Digital Literacy Program? Next question. With which company has Tata Trust collaborated to launch the Internet Sathi Digital Literacy Program? Apple, Microsoft, Facebook, Google, or Yahoo? Let's have the answer, guys. Harshal says Google, option D. Paltu says, Jahasab says Facebook. Asha says Microsoft. Okay, all three have come out with three different answers. Now everybody is saying Google. Okay, let's have the look at the answer. Google India and Tata Trust will extend their Internet Sathi Digital Literacy Program in Punjab and Orissa to enhance digital literacy. Internet Sathi was launched in the year 2015. That's another question that can be asked. Next question. Where is India's largest hydropower project, Dibang Multipurpose Power Project, being built? India's largest hydropower project, Dibang Multipurpose Project, where is it being built? Delhi, Arunachal Pradesh, Tripura, Manipur, or Mizoram? India's largest hydropower project, Dibang Multipurpose Project, where is it being built? Let's have the answer, guys. Arunachal. Sagarika says Arunachal. Everybody else says Arunachal, because Dibang is in Arunachal. Nice one. Yes, India's largest hydropower project, Dibang Multipurpose, is being built in Arunachal. In case you don't know, Dibang is on the left, on the right hand corner of Arunachal. So if this is, let's say Arunachal is like this, it's coming out like this, right? So this here, Dibang enters Arunachal like this. So you have Dihang and Dibang, I believe. Those are the two rivers that come simultaneously into India from the right hand corner of Arunachal. Nice one. What is the timeline proposed by... Yes, Brahmaputra flowing in Arunachal, and there are two rivers that are made out from there. Timeline proposed by IBC 2019 for resolution of cases. Very important question. This, I believe, is certainly going to be asked in the examination. Timeline proposed by IBC 2019 for resolution of cases. Let's have the answer, guys. 330, 90, 180, 270, or 130. A lot of you are going to get confused on this one. 330, is it the new timeline or the older timeline? Everybody says 330. Puneet says D. D is 270. Arundhati says 180. Let's have a look. Cabinet approved IBC to implement 7 amendments. Deadline within 330 days against the 270 days limit at present. That means 60 days added, including all litigation and judicial process. Votes of all financial creditors covered under IBC shall be cast in accordance with decision approved by the highest voting share, more than 50% of financial creditors on present and voting. So now, voting it has been made as 50%. Allows creditors who voted against the majority to receive a minimum liquidation value. IBC's resolution plan to be binding on all the stakeholders. Mergers and acquisitions are now a part of bankruptcy resolution. Next question, how many people were lifted out of poverty according to India's Multidimensional Poverty Index 2019? So MPI 2019, how many people lifted out of poverty? Let's have the answer, guys. 271 million. If I increase the speed, Bankwala, you might not understand a lot of things, or if you are understanding, others might leave it out. So let's keep the speed as at a generous position. C, everybody says C. Let's come to the answer. UN Development Program along with Oxford Poverty and Human Development Initiative have released the Multidimensional Poverty Index 2019. What is the total number? 1.3 billion people are multidimensionally poor in 103 countries. How many people? 103 billion people multidimensionally poor in 101 countries. A very important fact. 886 million live in middle income countries out of this 1.3 billion. India's NPI value reduced to 0.123. Very important. India and Cambodia are the fastest to reduce their multidimensional poverty. Lifted 271 million people out of poverty. So all these things that I'm marking are very important. Please mark them yourself as well. Parameters, 10 indicators are measured under three dimensions: health, education, and standard of living. Just like Human Development Index, the same indicators. Jharkhand has improved the most in reducing poverty. Another question there that can be asked. Okay, let's come to the next question. Let me zoom in a little bit. With which country has India signed inter-institutional agreement in the areas of regenerative medicine and 3D bioprinting? I'm not going to provide you all the other options. Let's have the answer, guys. With which country has India signed inter-institutional agreement for regenerative medicine and 3D bioprinting? Let's have the answer, guys. Please write down your answers. I will be sharing the PDF file. Don't worry about that. All these questions are from Spotlight. So if you have done Spotlight, you should be able to answer them very easily. USA, USA. Herschel says USA. Everybody says USA. Let's see if USA is in the options. Yes, it is option E. So whoever agrees with USA can write option E. Others can write anything else that they think is the right answer. Everybody thinks USA is the right answer. An agreement between India and USA for regenerative medicine and 3D bioprinting. That's all that's important here. Let's come to the next question. Which ministry has launched the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center scheme? Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center scheme. Which ministry has launched this scheme? Ministry of Electronics, MeitY, Ministry of Law, Ministry of Home Affairs, MWCD, or Ministry of Social Justice? Let's have the answer, guys. Which ministry has launched the Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center scheme? Vivek says B, Ministry of Law and Justice. Rajneesh says C, Ministry of Home Affairs. Some people saying C, some people saying E, Ministry of Social Justice. Some people saying A, MeitY. You want me to zoom in a little or zoom out? If I zoom out, then you will see other information also. That's why I have zoomed in. Ministry of Human Home Affairs, let's see what is the answer. MHAS launched the scheme Indian Cyber Crime Coordination Center to combat cyber crime. Okay, period 2018 to 2020, that's also important. Which naval ship has been flagged off as part of Sagar Maitri mission? Let's have the answer, guys. Chakra, Chennai, Tarkash, Vikramaditya or Sagar Dhwani? Which naval ship has been flagged off as a part of Sagar Maitri mission? Saranya says E, Sagar Dhwani. Sarvagya says C, E, Sagar Dhwani, E, Sagar Dhwani. Everybody says E, Sagar Dhwani. Rashi says D, Vikramaditya. Harshal says Sagar Dhwani. Tarkash, Rishikesh says INS Tarkash. So some confusion here. Okay, in case your answer gets wrong, don't worry about it. That means you will never forget it now. Sagar Dhwani, option E, a marine acoustic research ship has been flagged off for second Sagar Maitri. Okay. It will visit Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore and Indonesia to initiate joint research programs. First Sagar Maitri mission was held in April 2019 with INS Sagar Dhwani visiting Myanmar. Okay. Next question. Which among the following has become the first PSU to establish a GEM Organizational Team Project Management Unit, GOTT PMU, by signing an agreement with the Government E-Marketplace, GEM? Which PSU has established GOTT PMU by signing an agreement with GEM? Let's have the answer, guys. The options are B, HEL, NALCO, NTPC, IOC, Steel Authority of India. That's all. We have five options. Yes, five options are here. SAIL, Steel Authority of India. E, so Sarvagya says E. Harshal says E. Sagarika says E. Everybody says E. Let's see. Yes, the answer is SAIL is going to be the first PSU to establish GOTT PMU. I hope there's nothing else to mention there. Next question, where will the India's first space tech park be opened? India's first space technology park. Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Odisha or Telangana? The answer for the last one was SAIL. India's first space tech park. Where is this going to be opened? Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, Odisha or Telangana? Hyderabad in Telangana. So, Jasleen says E, Shubham says C, Kerala, everyone else saying Asha says E, therefore confusion between Kerala and Telangana. First space tech park, is it Kerala or is it Telangana? India's first space tech park in Thiruvananthapuram in Kerala. Vikram Sarabhai Space Center will provide complete investment, not important from examination point of view. So, the answer is Kerala and not Telangana. Which state has launched India's first garbage cafe? India's first garbage cafe became very popular. Telangana, Mizoram, Sikkim, Goa or Chhattisgarh? Sagarika got it right. Space Museum in Andhra. Space Park in Kerala. Rishabh says Chhattisgarh E. Everybody is saying Chhattisgarh E. Any confusion here? Yes, Chhattisgarh's Municipal Corporation has launched India's first garbage cafe where you can bring in your garbage. Rag pickers can bring garbage and they'll get food for free. So that's the objective and their garbage will be weighed and they will be provided equal amount of money. Bank wala, everybody else agrees with the speed. Let's not increase the speed. Let's stay where we are. We are not in a hurry. The objective is to learn it right. Hand in hand is a joint military exercise between which all countries? Let's have the answer, guys. China, Malaysia, India, Sri Lanka, Japan, South Korea, Russia, Japan, or India, China. A very popular exercise which is held every year. Yes, the answer is, yes, the answer is right, India, China. India, China will hold the 8th edition of their annual joint military exercise in Meghalaya this year. Where will the 11th edition of Defence Expo 2020 be organized? The 11th edition of Defence Expo 2020, where is it going to be organized? The 11th edition of Defence Expo. Karnataka, Maharashtra, New Delhi, Uttar Pradesh or Uttarakhand? Let's have the answer, guys. Somebody says New Delhi, 11th edition of Defence Expo. Somebody says Lucknow, Uttar Pradesh. Delhi LKO. UP LKO. A lot of confusion there. Confusion between C and D. See, this is where students get the answers wrong. 11th edition going to be held in Lucknow LKO in UP. The theme is also important. Please remember this. India, the emerging defence manufacturing hub. So remember the theme as well. That can also be asked in the examination. Next question. Between which two countries has Motihari Amlekhganj Petroleum Products Pipeline been established? Between which two countries is this pipeline being established? Motihari Amlekhganj Petroleum Pipeline. India-Pakistan, India-Bangladesh, India-Nepal, India-Myanmar or India-China. I think it's a very obvious answer. You should not go wrong. Rishabh says India-Nepal. Paltu says India-Nepal. Everybody says India-Nepal. Yes. Amlekhganj and Motihari. No information there. Let's come to the next one. Recently, an inter-ministerial committee has presented the draft Banning of Cryptocurrency and Regulation of Official Digital Currency Bill to Ministry of Finance. Who is the head of this committee? Let's have the answer, guys. Abhishek, don't worry, I will repeat it now. Okay, let's have the answers of this question. Let's see who gets it right first. The Committee on Banning of Cryptocurrency. These are the options. Timothy, Rishabh says Timothy Gonsalves. Saranya says Subhash Chandra Garg. Anivesh says Subhash Chandra Garg. Somebody says B.N. Sri Krishna also. So the options are confusing here. What does Abhishek say? Did not get your answer there. D.D.D. S.C. Garg D. Majority students saying D. Okay, so somebody's got it right. Somebody's got it wrong this time. Let's see. The IMC, Interministerial Committee, set up under Subhash Chandra Garg to look into the feasibility of cryptocurrency, has presented the draft of this particular bill. The bill imposes a fine and imprisonment of up to 10 years for offences related to cryptocurrency, and the draft bans the use of cryptocurrency in India. This is the most important of the recommendations of this committee. Next question, what is the current sex ratio per 1,000 males at the national level according to the latest government survey? 990, 921, 876, 800 and 896. Sex ratio, current sex ratio. If I zoom it out, Chinmaya, then the problem is that you will see other information as well. That's why I've zoomed in so that you can see the question at least. Try and not look at the options, not depend on the options. What should be the answer? Somebody says 922, it's not one of the options. Somebody says E896, these are the options. So sex ratio at birth is different from child sex ratio. is different from normal sex ratio. 896 and 921, that's the confusion here. Let's go to this SRS, sample registration survey, which I believe I've already provided to the students, and some video was also created on the same. The sex ratio has declined to 896 in the 3 years from 898. Okay, so it has declined to 896. Population census, the ratio was 940 females to 1000 males in the population census of 2011. Highest sex ratio, Chhattisgarh, Haryana, lowest at 833. Some other information provided by SRS are being mentioned here. Infant mortality rate, 33. Infant mortality rate is IMR at 33. Highest IMR in Madhya Pradesh and lowest in Kerala. Infant mortality of rural India is 37 and in urban India it was 23. SRS 2017 shows that total fertility rate has fallen to 2.2 per women, which is close to replacement rate of 2.1 that I already discussed in the SRS video also. Let's come to the next question. Which state has launched Mission Shakti to groom the talented sport persons from remote tribal regions for the 2024 Paris Olympiad? Mission Shakti launched by which state? Mission Shakti launched by which state for promoting tribal regions for 2024 Paris Olympiad? Yes, additional data important for phase 1, very important for phase 1. Paltu says Maharashtra. Let's have the answer, guys. First question where students are thinking a lot before answering. Neha, Rashi, Rishikesh, Sarvagya, Chinmaya, Deepti, everybody says Maharashtra. Parul, Rohit, Abhishek, everybody says Maharashtra. My brother is posted in Maharashtra as a district magistrate, I believe DM or something of that kind. And he tells me the talent of these, he's posted in a remote location in Maharashtra, and he tells me about the talent of these tribal people, especially in sports like archery, where people, these kind of people are not promoted or not pushed, and they can get us medals in various international competitions. So he's also trying to work on something like that. Maharashtra had launched Mission Shakti in 2018 to groom the talented sport persons from remote tribal regions. Actor Aamir Khan has joined this mission, and now it is being extended to various regions of Maharashtra. So that is another question that can also be asked in the examination. Next question, who heads the National List of Essential Medicines Committee, NLEM committee, which shortlists essential medicines on which the price control needs to be applied? Balram Bhargav, Bhishma Bhargav, Vikram, Bhuvan or Raghukant Bhargav? Let's have the answer, guys. Let's have the answer, guys. This is the second last question. We limit our session to 50 questions only. Balram, everybody says no. Some people are saying A, some people are also saying C. C is Vikram Bhargav. So is the answer Balram Bhargav or Vikram Bhargav? Dia also says Vikram Bhargav. All the others are saying Balram Bhargav, Balram or Vikram. NLEM committee headed by Balram Bhargav, option A, will shortlist essential medicines. The shortlisted drugs will be included schedule 1 of DPCO. Last question, which of the following statement is not true about Pradhan Mantri Laghu Vyapari Mandhan Yojana? An important question specifically from phase 2 point of view can also be asked in phase 1. Because it's an important scheme. Pradhan Mantri Laghu Vyapari Mandhan Yojana. Options are, the scheme is for SME traders. The scheme provides special provision for women entrepreneurs. The scheme covers 3 crore small shopkeepers and traders. The scheme has a fixed pension of 3000 rupees. Retail or self-employed traders with GST turnover below 1.5 crore and age between 18 to 40 can enroll for this scheme. All the best, Dipti. Nice one. Nice confidence there that I can see. So what we have to find? We have to find out the incorrect one. Scheme is for SME traders. The scheme provides special provision for women entrepreneurs. The scheme covers 3 crore small shopkeepers and traders. The scheme has a fixed pension of 3,000. And the last one is retail or self-employed traders with GST below 1.5 crore and age between 18 to 40 can enroll for this or in this scheme. Everybody says B is not for women entrepreneurs. Yes, it is for all the SME traders. Has been launched by Prime Minister as a part of Universal Social Security, which covers 3 crore small traders and shopkeepers. 3,000 will be given to retail traders and shopkeepers after 60 years of age. Turnover 1.5 crore, age group 18 to 40 for enrolling in this scheme. Okay, wonderful. We had a very nice session. Let me open up the other screen. Okay, nice one here. So this was all about this session. We have covered a lot of questions, a total of 17 pages in this July flashcard. Although these sessions are long, but they're very fruitful. I can make sure that if you cover these sessions thoroughly along with coverage of flashcards and spotlight, there is no way that you can get less than 60. Everything else depends upon your static as well, because 10 to 20, anything between 10 and 20 come from the static GK as well. Okay. It's already more than 1 hour, 1.5 hours. That's why I wanted to end up the session. We'll have the session again probably tomorrow morning. Yes, I'm holding another session at 10 a.m. The objective is to tell you guys how to prepare in the remaining 12 days, what to do. So this session is not for people who are starting this preparation now. Let me be very clear about that. Okay. The session is not for students who are starting their prep now, because then there is no hope, but for them who are revising. Majority of us are revising now. Okay. We'll have a session tomorrow morning at probably 10 o'clock. I'll be sending the mails. Keep checking your mails, because that's the only way for me to connect with you guys. And through that mail, I'll tell you when the session is, and we'll be discussing how to study for the next 12 days, what to revise, what not to revise, how to take care of the sectional timing, and I'll be taking your doubts. Okay. All the very best. Take care. I hope you learned something new today. Happy Diwali.